Hello. I'm gonna get started in just about a minute. Wait for a couple people to get back on, to get online. Just letting some music play right now. Just starting to get your bodies warm a little bit. In case we don't, like the tough areas that take a while to get warm. Then we're gonna get started. So today we're gonna start standing.
Tilt the camera a little bit.
Start standing. We're gonna start with the top of our head. Going in a circle, up and down. Each shoulder. Just finding the range of motion. The head and neck. Try to keep your shoulders down and relaxed. Try to work out those kinks that you have in your body. If you need a moment to just rest in a position to get a nice stretch, do so. Allow your hands to come to your head for a deeper stretch if you need. I keep shifting my weight because I want to get used to the shifting of the weight today. Personally, you don't have to. You can just stand still, whichever you like. Let's move to the shoulders, up and down. Forward and back, circular, forward and back in space. You can move them together, you can move in opposition. Whichever you like. Ribcage, forward and side and back. Diagonally undulate through the spine. Whatever feels good for you. Let's explore that in this warm up. Again, you can shift your weight between your feet or not. Just try to keep the knees soft. Slight demi-plié. You can get the shoulders involved a little bit too, if you like. Just let the head go for a ride. You don't necessarily have to move it with intention. Just let the focus be the ribs and everything else follows as you're shifting your weight. You can find moments like that with myself where you lose your balance, but you find your center again. Hips side to side. My hips are a little tight today. Forward and back, circular, or if that is for you. And again, this is all about exploration, what your body is capable of. You may have more movement in the hips or less, it doesn't matter. Just keep exploring what that is for you. And if you want to expand on that, keep exploring ways to do so. Shifting the weight. Allowing the hips to be the initiator and the ribs, spine, shoulders, head are just going for the ride. Knees. Shifting the weight now, if you haven't been doing so. A little nice plie and rise, shifting back and forth. You don't have to go all the way up to your tippy toes or to releve, but just nice stretch, bend and stretch in the legs. Ankles, just do some ankle circles. Flexing and pointing, getting the toes involved. Same thing, other side. Let's do the wrists as well while we're doing the feet. Flexing and pointing. Awesome, shake it out. All the tension in your body that you have. Nice. Let's make our way to the floor. We're going to start in our X position. Legs slightly wider than our shoulders. Making a star or X on the floor. You soften the eyes or close your eyes. Breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth. Inhaling and exhaling. Each exhale, find yourself sinking more and more into the floor. Try to find that connection with the earth and with your breath. You can make minor adjustments here if you need. If you feel like your body needs those adjustments, you can do so. You don't have to stand lie completely still. Our bodies are ever changing and ever evolving. But as best as you can, try to remain
one with the floor or with the earth. I'm gonna do something slightly different today. We're gonna start with our improvisation on the floor instead of doing another warm-up on the floor. And we're going to come back to this exposition when we're done. I'm gonna stay connected with the floor as long as we can. Moving different body parts away from the floor or away from the earth. And then finding that connection back with the floor. Make sure your breath is involved. Try to connect with the music. Or try to go against the music. That's a choice as well. Just make sure that whatever you do that is intentional. Like your moments of stillness, or your sharp moments, or the moments that are continuous and flowy. Try not to get stuck. With the routine, if you like to be a continuous mover, try to have more moments of stillness. If you're a very sharp mover, try to have flowier moments. You get it. Challenge yourselves. I like to move in a flow, so I'm going to do sharper movements. But try not to stay on that path. Still adding some flowy movements in here, and some stillness, while still trying to connect with the movement, excuse me, the music. And when you find an ending, let's go back into our exposition. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Breathing in and out. A few more breaths here. Let's draw the knees into our chest, wrapping our hands around, clasping, hugging our knees, shins. Try to keep your low back on the floor. You can rock side to side, forward and back, whatever you need. Try to get a low back massage. Let's go back into our X position. And let's slowly come up to a seated position. So, that was a good little warm-up for me. I don't know how all of you felt about that, but it feels really good. I hope you feel a bit warmer Now, today we are going to focus our improv like we've been doing, low, medium, high, playing with resistance, playing with timing, playing with facing. And I want to add a little bit more today. I want us to focus on emotion. So having an intention in the emotion that you're trying to convey to your audience. So it's a little bit more performance aspect in our improvisation today. So today, I'm gonna stand up a little bit. I'm gonna start in our low, medium, and high level all at once. And let's start with our initiators today. So I want us to start with our hands and our sternum. How our hands and the sternum can guide us through space. Just as a warm-up, focusing on those initiators. Let's do shoulders and elbows. Let's do feet. We can still find moments of stillness. Playing with tempo as well. Things like that, yeah. So now, let's add our emotion to it. So let's start with happy. So that's a great emotion, right? Still keeping our feet and our head as the initiator. Move on to sad. Okay.
surprised. Worried. Calm. Angry. Beautiful. Yeah, I hope you had fun exploring those emotions, just with head and feet, as much as I did. Let's do those again, those emotions, just with a different initiator. So I'm gonna give you the time to, heads chopped off. I'm gonna give you the time to pick out whatever one or however many initiators you would like to do this next part, but I will direct you in what emotions we're gonna go through. Sorry, I'm like completely out of breath right now. So my initiator is going to be my, let's see, needs. Sad. Happy. Angry. Calm. Silly. calm. Let's slowly move to our X position as we come to an end. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Feel the difference in your body in this X position than the previous one. Try to slow your heart rate down with each breath. You can close your eyes here or soften as you look up towards the ceiling. With each breath, try your best to connect more and more to the floor, to the earth. Did your movement exploration help you today? Especially with exploring different types of emotions through movement. Roll over to either side into a fetal position. Slowly come up to a seated position.
Awesome work today. Thank you so much for joining me. And I would like to say, if you have any questions or comments or concerns, just post to this video. Thank you so much.